FM News. On point.
Click at the news. Former presidential candidate Robert Chabanyi Sentamu has filed an application before the Supreme Court withdrawing his presidential election petition. Chabanyi filed a petition in the same court challenging the presidential election results where he lost to NRM's flag bearer Yoweri Museveni. In his application, Chabanyi says most of his witnesses have been abducted, intimidated, tortured and harassed by security organs to the advantage of the first respondent, who is the president-elect. Chabanyi adds that his party offices in Kamocha were besieged by security, whereas the same security legally detained him at his home for almost 2 weeks illegally, and he lost a lot of time. He further says he has not entered into any agreement with respondents by any corruption, background, or any other consideration to withdraw his petition. His lawyer, Mered Lubega Segona, says his affidavit supporting the withdrawal of the case will be filed today.
The application was filed according to plan, period. We are not going to manage our case based on ignorance of those of the ignorant. We are going to manage our case based on our knowledge of the law, procedures and the processes of this court. Well, I've said that I can handle cases without being paid, especially matters of public interest like this one. But if they feel they should be enriched by some coins, we shall discuss that in court.
Justice Owinyi Dolo has asked the Attorney General, lawyers of President Yoweri Museveni and the Electoral Commission to file their response to Chagulanyi's application of withdrawing the presidential elections petition. Chagulanyi filed the application before the Supreme Court outlining 6 reasons compelling him to withdraw his petition, in which he was challenging the presidential election held 14th January. Justice Dolo says today, by close of business, Chagulanyi's lawyers should have filed affidavits as required by the Presidential Elections Petitions Rules 2001.
So we will proceed this way, as is provided for in the Act and the rules. By your own concession and undertaking, we will have the second affidavit required by the rules by close of business today. Subsequent to that, the application, a copy will be posted in our notice board. The Registrar of this Court will cause it to be gazetted in the Official Gazette. In the meantime, we expect the respondents to make whatever response they might want to make in writing, affidavit or whatever it is. And then once the notice comes out in the Gazette, we will give you the shortest notice to appear here for the hearing of the application. Until then, we are not able to proceed.
Dolo adds that hearing of the application to withdraw the petition will be fixed following the publishing of the case in the Gazette.
This is all about the importance of a presidential election petition, that it's not handled like the other matters between private individuals. The point we've been making here all along, that the petition that is in this court, it's about us, about this country. So even getting out has to go through this process. It's got to be public notice. That's why it has got to go to the Gazette and the notice board, that the petitioner wishes to withdraw, and then we will pronounce ourselves in accordance with the law on withdrawal.
Police in Ntinda is holding a youth suspected to have been leading a group of thugs who terrorized residents of Nakawa, stealing their number plates. Farouk Matavu, a 25 hawker and resident of Nakawa, Kampala, was arrested and led the police to the recovery of 9 number plates of different motor vehicles. It is alleged that Matavu told the officers how he has been stealing many number plates from areas of Ntinda, Chiwatwe, Kulambiro, Naguru and surrounding areas, where he moves at night, blacking off vehicle number plates and leaving behind a paper on the front screen of the car stating the telephone number to reach him to get back one's number plate. The deputy PRO Kampala Metropolitan, Luke OSG, says that they managed to recover number plates that include UBA670Q, UAT783Y, UAW379Y, UAR859K, UBB475N, UAR261K, UAJ019P, and UAH907Q from Chigoa, Northern Bypass, Chiwatwe, and Kulambilo.
He informed us how he has been stealing these number plates. He alleges that at around midnight he goes around different neighborhoods, plucking off number plates and then hiding them in the nearby places, where he later on calls the victims to give him money and recover their number plates. So investigations are ongoing, and more details will be availed at a particular time.
In other news, Rwanda's President Paul Kagame has faulted the hypocrisy and double standards in the global distribution of COVID-19 vaccines. President Kagame made the comments in a tweet after the World Health Organization director Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus said deals between rich nations and vaccine manufacturers had made it hard to acquire vaccines for its COVAX initiative. The COVAX is an initiative to ensure equitable distribution of the COVID-19 vaccine across all countries. Wealthy nations have been accused of hoarding these vaccines, making it hard for poor ones to access any. A coalition of campaign groups, People's Vaccine Alliance, warned in December that nearly 70 lower income countries will only be able to vaccinate one in 10 people. It called on all pharmaceutical corporations working on COVID-19 vaccines to openly share their technology and intellectual property so that billions more doses can be manufactured and made available to everyone that needs them. That was the news.
XFM News.